Are your Doc Martens looking dry, scuffed up, and shabby? Well, don't just throw them away. With the right skills and tools for the job, you can easily restore them and enjoy your shoes for years to come. Let's get to it. Hey guys, welcome back. My name's Evan, and it's my goal to share with you the skills and tools needed to love your leather. Now, as I always say, it's vitally important to understand the condition and cleanliness of your shoes in order to provide what's necessary to restore them. And at first glance, we see multiple issues such as dirt, dust, and debris, scuffing, dryness, frayed threads, and of course, discoloration, all of which are fixable, that is, with the right tools. Today is going to be special because I'll be doing an unboxing of new products sent to us by our friends over at Red Moose. Let's get to it. Alright, so first off we have the shoe polish kit. It includes two horsehair brushes. The bristles seem to be about the same, but the color's different, probably for what color polish you'll be using. Additionally, a soft cotton cloth to apply and buff the polish. Next, we have both a brown and a black cream polish, and the difference between wax polishes and cream polishes is that creams are mainly for recoloring pigment and nourishing your leather, while waxes build up a hard barrier and create a high shine. There's also two pairs of spare laces, one brown and one black. Next, we have the Instant Shoe Shine Sponge. This is one of my favorite tools when achieving a high shine because it removes any haziness from polishes. Though I've never seen one like this that has some type of shining solution soaked into it, but it'll be fun to use later on. The indispensable horsehair brush. Whether you're getting off dust or debris or ready to shine up your shoes, this type of brush should be in every gentleman or gentlewoman's arsenal, for that matter. Ladies, I know there can be a lot of fear in cleaning or restoring your leather because you don't want to ruin anything, but I have faith in you. A shoehorn. Okay, these are super underrated. Why? Because the reality is that most of us put on shoes at least a few times a week, and when it comes to leather, each time we shove our feet into our shoes, not only can it be hard and frustrating, but it takes a toll on the heel of our shoes. Using a shoehorn solves both of those problems, and it makes putting shoes on enjoyable and fast. For the love of shoes and the endless adventure, I love it. So this is supposed to be a sneaker care kit, but it says suede and nubuck, so let's go ahead and see what's inside. We have a standard microfiber cloth, indispensable as well. A foaming cleanser, that's gonna be fun. Oh yeah, I just wanted to see the foam. I couldn't wait. We also have a shoe deodorizer, which is fragrance-free and neutralizes odors. By the way, all of these products are made in the USA, which I support. Also, I appreciate the non-aerosol spray as well. Now, this little brush is a suede brush, which if you have sneakers that also have suede, this is the brush you'd want to use. Now, this brush has harder bristles. It's mainly going to be used for removing dirt and debris from your shoes before cleaning. This will come in handy so that when you begin to clean, you're not rubbing in dirt into the leather. And lastly, we have a suede eraser. Honestly, this is the hardest eraser I've ever felt, and it has absolutely no bend to it. Nonetheless, I haven't tried it yet, so it may work out very well. Overall, this gentleman's kit from Red Moose is definitely something that will set you up for almost any shoe restoration. And more than that, it sets you up to clean and maintain your shoes for years to come. Without further ado, let's get to cleaning. So for our first step, let's go ahead and brush off any dirt or debris so that we're not rubbing in anything that would scratch or damage the leather. Secondly, make sure you either remove or tuck away any of your laces so that they don't get in your way when you're working. And the moment we've all been waiting for, okay, maybe just me, the foam. It's vitally important to try your best to wipe off each section of your leather before moving forward, an effort to make sure that you don't saturate your leather because it can lead to damaging your leather in the long run. So why am I so fanatical about foam? Well, when it comes to cleaning your leather, you want to avoid saturating your leather with any liquid because you can damage it at a molecular level, which will lead to cracking. So having foam enables you to have a cleaner that won't penetrate the leather deeply because it only sits on the surface. Secondly, it makes cleaning faster since you don't have to spend time scrubbing to make the suds. And lastly, when it comes to ASMR, it's super satisfying to watch and hear. Make sure not to forget the tongue of your shoes or boots. This is a notorious spot for dirt, dust, and debris to hide and further ruin your leather. Now, because these docks were scuffed up so badly, we're actually going to scuff them some more. And what I mean by that is we're going to sand down any fibers that are standing up as well as even out the surfaces. I'd say most of you have access to a nail file, which tends to be around 150 to 200 grit sandpaper. But after that, we're going to use a smoother grit around 1000 grit to really even out the leather. Now make sure you guys don't push too hard or sand in one place for too long. Pro tip, use your fingers to feel the smoothness as you go. Next, to get rid of the discoloration as well as to nourish the leather, we're going to use our cream polish. This will give back the black pigment, hydrate the leather, and lastly, provide a light shine to the leather. In order to apply it properly, grab yourself a cotton cloth. You can cut up a t-shirt as well, and simply wrap two fingers into the cloth, twist until taut, then grab the excess with the rest of your fingers, and you're good to go. It's always best to use less at first and add more as needed. That way, you save the rest of the cream for another project as well as prevent caking the leather. And as you guys already see, the leather is just soaking up the cream and restoring the black pigment to the shoe. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Man, that looks so much better. And just continue the same process throughout the rest of the shoe. If you guys have to clean any dirty laces, you can do so by just using some cleaner. Just apply some foam, agitate them, or brush them like I'm doing here, and simply pull them through a cloth to remove any excess. As I always say, it's vitally important to fill out your leather to prevent creasing and cracking. Paper, plastic bags, and shoe trees are the best. Of course, don't overstuff your leather unless you're trying to purposefully stretch out your shoes to break them in. I honestly think that brushing is one of my favorite parts of the cleaning process because it's one of the last steps and brings this process to an end. Using a horsehair brush does two things. Number one, it disperses all of the waxes and oils evenly throughout the shoe, and number two, it creates a lustrous shine. The way we get a shine is by vigorously brushing back and forth, thus creating friction that gives us our shine. Make sure to stay in one place for long enough for the waxes to gently melt onto the leather. Alright guys, these shoes look great already, but I was really wanting to try this instant shine, so let's go for it. Of course, we already shined these shoes a little bit, but we did not use a wax polish, so inevitably our shine is going to be less when we use a cream versus a wax. And wow guys, they were not kidding when they said instant shoe shine. Let me know in the comments what you think below. One last finishing touch. If you guys have any loose threads, feel free to quickly sear them off with a flame. Just make sure not to stay in one area for too long, otherwise you may burn your leather. Alright guys, that is a wrap. I'm pretty surprised how quick and simple this restoration was, and it just shows how having the right tools for the right job makes a world of a difference. Now, this video was not sponsored, but it is supported by those of you who hit that like and subscribe button. Also, do your friends and neighbors a favor and send them a link over to my channel to learn as well. Please let me know if you guys have any questions or comments below. I'm always encouraged by your guys' support. Do check out Red Moose's website though. They have a great mission and their products are handcrafted in the USA. I hope that you guys enjoyed restoring these Doc Martens with me and learned some invaluable skills for your next projects. As always, remember to love your leather.